Wow! Guys, what you will see in this video is truly one of the coolest things we've ever done on this channel, and I cannot wait to show you. Today, we explore this newly created massive 35-foot-long ant farm setup I designed to house our newly caught Pharaoh ants from last week's video. And get this, it spans the entire ant room, winding through furniture and room decor with tubes that lead to some really cool living spaces. How has the Pharaoh ant colony been adjusting to these new enclosed territories? Did we catch a queen, and are there eggs? We even discover the colony's very first world event that posed a potential threat to their survival. So keep on watching until the very end. AC family, it's time to enter the interesting and unique world of our new Pharaoh ants and explore the new giant room-sized territory we've made for them in this eye-opening episode of the AntsCanada Ant Channel. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Welcome to the AC family. Tired of nature channels not showing nature shows? Just watch this channel. Enjoy. Last week, we watched with bated breath as we formulated some cool traps to capture sections of an intruding army of Pharaoh ants that were raiding our Garden of Eden, a terrarium belonging to our colony of marauder ants called the Titans. If you haven't seen last week's video yet, feel free to watch it here after watching this video. After isolating large sections of the colony, we were able to catch a good number of ants and turn the traps into actual terrariums. And as promised, it's time to show you, AC family, the home of our new Pharaoh ants. Once enemies, but now friends. But before we take a look at them, in last week's video, you, the AC family, voted for the official name of our Pharaoh ants. AC family, I am happy to announce that this new colony of ours is officially called the Tomb Raiders. Look at them! Amazing! They're still new in this setup, and they've chosen to camp out together in one area, but we'll get back to them in a second. Let's take our first walk through their majestic properties. Alright, let's start here, in what I call the Valley of the Kings, named after the famous valley in Egypt where for a period of 500 years, tombs were excavated for the pharaohs and powerful nobles of the 18th to 20th dynasties of ancient Egypt. It's a simple plot of land with soils from the Garden of Eden, so it contains springtails to help with breaking down any waste left in the valley. I consider it the Tomb Raiders' valley area, as it is the lowest point of their entire property. Moving up the west side of the Valley of the Kings, we make our way up into Nefertiti's Tunnel, named after the famous Egyptian queen, and it's here where our Tomb Raiders are camped out now. Not sure why they've elected this area as the main nesting camp, but they are really digging Nefertiti's tunnel. Now, one of my concerns through all of this was whether or not we managed to catch a fertilized egg-laying queen. Pharaoh ant colonies, which can be absolutely massive, can contain hundreds of egg-laying queens. The technical term describing this is polygyny. Pharaoh ants are a polygynous species, and the queens themselves are daring enough to leave the safety of their nests to actually feed out in the open with the rest of the colony on site. We saw this in a previous video. This was advantageous for us because during the whole trapping process last week, I did make sure to capture a few queens. And look, here is one now. But here's the thing. Yes, we had queens, but the question was whether these queens were fertilized queens. They could have been unmated virgin alate queens, which of course meant that they couldn't lay eggs and perpetuate the colony. Without a fertilized egg-laying queen ant, our Tomb Raiders would all die out in just a few months. But look, just 2 days after living in their new home, our Tomb Raiders are tending to growing piles of brood. It was great news to know that one of the queens in here was actually laying fertile eggs. It's hard to see through the polyvinyl tubing, but it does look like we have some eggs and even larvae. Check out the size of this larva, which was filmed only 5 days after moving in, which means it developed from egg to mature larva in just 5 days. That is insane growth. It seems our Tomb Raiders don't waste any time at creating workers. I feel they're on the road to growing into a really impressive army. Another reason why seeing this brood develop so quickly was a relief was because when Pharaoh ants hold their feeding raids, they leave all their young back home wherever they're nesting. A smart move, But because our trapping system last week involved using food bait to capture our tomb raiders, none of the colony we captured contained brood. And considering that worker ants only survive for 2 months tops, it meant that we would have a bunch of ants dying out over a 2 month period, and eventually nobody would be around to take care of the succeeding generation of ants and the queens. But no need for us to worry about that now, as our tomb raiders are thriving in their new home. And hey, will you look at that? It seems some straggler tomb raiders from the outside, members who weren't caught, have discovered their family and are trying ever so desperately to find a way inside. I'll tell you how I deal with these stragglers later. But let's move on. Nefertiti's tunnel opens up into the Tomb Raider's next home. Behold, the Garden of Anubis. Another beautiful and simple living area with soils from the Garden of Eden, also containing springtails. From here, we enter the Nubian Shelf, which extends eastward, but also comes to a fork. Let's take a moment to move upwards. So check this out, AC family. From the Nubian Shelf, the Tomb Raiders can choose to climb what I call the Pyramid's Rise, which takes them directly into a completely dry, desert landscape of rocks and sands called the Rosetta Stone Desert. Named after the famous ancient Egyptian stone containing text written by a group of priests in Egypt to honor the Egyptian pharaoh. This neat desert terrain in the Tomb Raiders Highlands is left completely dry. The reason is because, as a general rule, an effective ant setup provides the ants with both a humid area and a dry area. You essentially want to give the ants a humidity gradient and the chance to hydroregulate, meaning allowing them to move to whatever area they want according to their humidity preferences. This is especially important for the young, meaning eggs, larvae, and pupae, whose humidity needs are a lot more critical to survival than the adults. The Rosetta Stone Desert provides our tomb raiders with a dry escape if they ever need it. The succulent plant at the back is artificial, and I don't intend to add any water or food in here. It is just barren land. Perhaps the ants may choose to use this as the colony's sacred burial grounds. We'll see. By the way, all of these terrariums you see here are designed with the help of cool AC biome kits from our shop at AntsCanada.com, which contain various decorations to help you design the perfect habitat and terrarium for your ants. Another thing you might notice is the large rock positioned at the back. Legend has it that this rock is a piece broken off from ancient hydrostone from a past extinct world in AC lore. Perhaps those of you AC family who've been subscribed to the channel for years may recall its origins. So let's backtrack to the Nubian Shelf, where we descend down Cairo's Drop and come to Club Oasis. Of course, our tomb raiders need fresh and clean water. This hydro station, which was built from an AC test tube adapter and an AC test tube, offers the colony some clean water at any time they need it. What's interesting is that not every ant needs to visit it. The tomb raiders simply send some messenger ants to drink from it, fill up their social stomachs, then return to the colony to distribute the water through mouth-to-mouth regurgitation transfer. These ants act as living water servants, visiting Club Oasis frequently and making sure all ants, queens, and young are hydrated properly. It's an effective system because it means not all members of the colony need to risk their lives by leaving the protection of the camp. Moving downwards, we enter the Garden of Alexandria. After a good hydration, our tomb raiders can relax in this space on Garden of Eden soils before taking the longest trek in their setup on the journey to the next terrarium. Now, AC family, are you ready for this? As we saw in last week's video, we learned that our tomb raiders love to travel and are highly nomadic. So, from the Garden of Alexandria, the ants embark on a 25-foot journey up the Pharaoh's Rise, behind my curtain, and across the Great Bridge of Horus. Named after the Egyptian sky god, the Bridge of Horus winds around my curtain rod and emerges in the eastern territories of the Tomb Raiders, down into what I call the Osiris Underpass, named after the ancient Egyptian god of the underworld. I just love watching the ants traveling through this stretch of tunnel. Coming from the other end of the Osiris Underpass, we enter the Sphinx Staircase, and we finally end here at the easternmost territories of the Tomb Raiders, a place known as the Field of Eru, named after the Egyptian mythological heavenly paradise to which souls who qualified on their great journey in the afterlife remain to rest. And this AC family is the vast home of our Tomb Raiders, a 35-foot stretch of fertile land for the Tomb Raiders to enjoy and travel through. Size-wise, it doesn't beat our Dark Knight's territories, which spans over 40 feet of travel area, but for an ant whose workers are twice as small as those of the Dark Knights, the Tomb Raiders actually have the bigger space to travel relative to their size. And guess what? This colony is about to get lucky. It's feeding time. Today I placed a pre-killed cockroach into the Garden of Anubis. It wasn't long before the ants moved in to feast. Not all of them, of course. Only the food servants. They would then bring the food back to the rest of the colony, stored in their social stomachs. Now, as the ants were eating, I noticed something strange. Wait a sec. Oh no! AC family, look! Alien mold! This is very bad news. Oh boy, it looks like our Tomb Raiders are about to head off on a rough start. Stay tuned next week for the continuation of this epic ant story. But hey, if you enjoyed this video and want to help these ants out, be sure to hit that like button, leave me a comment, share this video with your friends, and if you're not AC family yet, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button and bell icon to be notified every time we upload a video. AC Inner Colony, I have left a hidden cookie for you here if you would just like to watch some extended play footage of our Tomb Raiders living in their new setup. Now before we proceed to the AC question of the week, I have an awesome announcement to make. The holiday spirit is in the air, and as we do every year at AntsCanada, we are having our huge Christmas sale. This year, our brand new Hybrid Nest 2.0 and our All You Need Hybrid Nest gear pack are 15% off. Yes, 15% off these brand new items. So if you've always wanted to get into ant keeping, I have left some links in the description box to these sale items so you can pick up one for yourself or someone you love this Christmas. We ship worldwide, but just a reminder, you must order before December 18th to get your order before Christmas, so get it ASAP. But if you're not fussy about getting the item before Christmas Day, this Christmas sale, as usual, will continue until January the 1st, 2018. And we also have gift cards, in case you would like to get your special loved one an ant setup but aren't sure what they would want. I'd love for you guys to keep ants with us on this channel and discover how amazing these creatures are in real life. Alright, and now it's time for the AC question of the week. In last week's video, we asked, list any one of the phases of our ant trapping process. Congratulations to No Name Nation, who correctly answered Phase 6, Captivity. We also accepted phase 1, locate the site of the colony, phase 2, the line of death, phase 3, setting of the traps, phase 4, removal, and phase 5, precautionary maintenance. Congratulations, No Name Nation, you just won a free ebook handbook from our shop. In this week's AC question of the week, we ask, name any one of the sites in the Tomb Raider setup. Leave your answer in the comment section and you could win a free ant t-shirt from our shop. Hope you can subscribe to the channel as we upload every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video to help us keep making more. It's Ant Love Forever.